Okay, that's recording. That's recording. Let's do this. Everybody doing? I'm gonna make sure I got all my stuff squared away. Oh man, Tuesday evening, commuting home. So for those of you wondering why you're watching this, if you're wondering about switching away from your car, just gotta make sure that does not look right, to an e-bike, this will be your channel to watch. I've been doing this for, there we go, looks about right. Doing this for over a year now. Go about 8 miles each way. There's bugs, so excuse me. Doing this, do pedal assist. Where's the mic? There it is. Let me take care of that. So, long day. Yeah, I'm doing that contest. It's a garage door buddy guy. Gave me that monitor. Thanks, guys. So I'll share that with somebody who wants to do that. By the way, you can do this on the, I don't know if you knew that, but the fat tires let you kind of do crazy stuff if you wanted to. I personally choose not to. Yeah, so thank you to Garage Door Buddy people. Hopefully I can make somebody's day. We'll share that with one of the winners. You just got to subscribe and then put a comment in the old contest and I will ship it to you. Let's see what we got here. Oh, that thing keeps pulling. I think I got to fix the camera. Fix that thing. Hang on a sec, guys. Because last time I had this red line, it was kind of jacked up. Yeah, see, it keeps moving. All right, so bear with me here. We're gonna fix this. There. Now, that's a winner. We don't have anything going on there. Trying to do my best here, guys. Okay, now that's gonna be even more solid too, so that's good. Okay, there. And now I gotta do mic check. It's not easy doing all this stuff. I don't even know why I'm doing this. Now I am. I know I wanted to, well, that's a cool looking dog. It's the end of my day, guys, so I apologize. These random thoughts going through my head, I gotta try to focus. So yeah, I know when I was first looking to buy electric bike, I would have loved to have somebody who really committed to show me what it's like to do this every single day, committing, so. I'm hoping this helps. I'm getting some positive feedback from you guys that are watching. So I'm gonna stand up and pedal. So I'm doing pedal assist with the full throttle down. All right. What else was I gonna say? So I talked about the monitor thing, the garage door and the contest. What else did I have? Some other things they're talking about. So the fender and the light that it came with, I gotta remove that. See if I got time to do that today. Because I don't like the flappy noise it makes. See if I can simulate that for you guys. It's kind of a flapping. I just don't like that sound. And as you guys know, I'm not looking to bike in the rain anymore. It's just not my gig. Now, some of you certainly, if you want to do that, go for it. I know if you're from Seattle, you have to, or you would never do anything. So, yeah, and it's still doable. I just didn't really enjoy it, and I don't want to, so I can do that. I was gonna talk about something else. Oh yeah, I had a thought about that too, is that I remember when I was first looking to get an electric bike, I thought to myself, you know, it's a lot of money. It made me nervous, and I was like, worried about, well, what if I need a car for something? You know, I have two daughters, might have to go somewhere. And so then I thought, well, I could Uber Lyft. And then the funny part is too, like getting a car, you're committing to such a huge financial. Hey, look at all these nice cars driving around, and it's such a, I mean, most people don't pay cash, right? That's what I was consulting I used to. Those were good days. But for the most part, you lease or you buy, and you're signing yourself up for a big commitment. And everybody's okay with that for some reason. Yet, you know, the $1,800 bike, or what could be potentially a $1,000 bike, if you get some of these other ones that are out, people get nervous about that. So you just gotta flip it around mentally and think, well, if I live about 8 miles away, I could justify, it's hard to talk on this, I can justify the bike. I don't know, I guess you gotta look at it too, like my dad was looking to get an electric bike, I think I've mentioned that. He's worried about if something goes wrong with it, how can he get it serviced? Well, a lot of the bike companies, even Rad, they'll work with you. I really haven't had any major problems. I've had some people, I saw the other guy that I follow has got one of these things. He had the control unit or something, was sending voltage to the front light, even though the front light wasn't on. I don't know. I don't know if mine's doing that or not. I don't really have a meter to check that. And I'm not really worried about it right now, to be honest, because this does the job. And I'm sure to some extent, if it's happening, it's probably chewing up some battery power, but oh well. Anywho, my point is, really, when you think about it, you don't need a car. The funny part is now, I was talking about that with my wife, we're kind of stuck now because we thought about moving a little further away, then I would need to get a car and all the added expense that comes with it. So that puts me back up to the 300, and then my work gives me $100 a month credit for not taking a car. I don't even know if I did the math on that when I did my recap video. I don't think I did. But that's another $1,200 a year that I'm getting paid not to bring in a car to work. Excuse the cough. So it's getting harder to rationalize me ever owning a car again. That's it. I just have to be on a bicycle the rest of my life. Or an Uber vehicle, you know, for the temporary times. You can't do that all the time, obviously, but I'm just a little worried that I'm stuck now. Like, there's nothing else I could do. Now, I must say, at least I move my legs. Like, right now, I'm just loosely pedaling while we go, but my hand, you can't see it, my hand is on the motorcycle throttle on this thing, and I'm pedaling. So what's happening is I'm like barely helping the bike. It's doing most of the work, but my legs are getting a little bit of a circulatory workout. And after sitting or standing all day, I do have a desk that goes up and down, but you know, when you're standing, the most you could do is go through some emails, blah, 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 a couple things. But I think, like, when you're really cramming, doing, like, the really brain-intensive work, I think you have to sit, in my opinion. So anybody standing at your office probably isn't really working that hard, is my opinion. I think you have to be sitting to really get that good, like, either if you're a programmer, you know what I'm talking about. I think really getting that good coding going on, you got a couple of good 22-inch screens. Got your laptop screen on top of that, gets you three screens. Boom, 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 dragging and dropping stuff all over the place. You got to sit. That's my opinion. Leave a comment below. So, yeah. What else? I've seen that kid before walking on the trail there. Now, walking's an option too, but I don't think this is viable because you'd have to live within a couple of 2-3 miles. I don't think you could do better than that. This is the part I don't like. I forgot to put on my reflective. In the morning, I always remember to do that. Got the little reflective vest and the reflective sleevey thing. And I always forget on the way home to do that. So many things to remember. Oh yeah, these Maxxis tires, by the way. I love these things. They are, they're working really well. They're lasting a long time. Way longer than the ones that it came with. No offense to the rad folks. I know they don't make tires, but the tire they selected anyway. But this Maxxis tire is freaking awesome. The one thing I will say is once your tires get low, the bike turns into a hell of a lot more fun because you want to slide, lock up your wheels, wah, all that cool stuff. It makes you feel young again-ish. It's like when I first got this bike, if you look at some of my early videos, I would just, I'm more of a maniac than I am now. I'm very respectful. Now, but I was like cruising through some signs, shouldn't have, so my bad. Not anymore though. I stop, I do everything I'm supposed to do. Not that I was technically doing anything wrong, but it just kind of like felt, yeah, I was. All right, this is the crazy merge I can't stand. I don't know about where you guys live, but there's definitely sections of the road you get familiar with and you're like, I hate this section, just because you feel way more exposed than most. Like, I'm so lucky because most of my biking is on a trail. So that's another bonus, right? I think the key is living within 8 miles and having mostly bike trail. It's just so nice. If you're not in that situation in your city and it's hilly and things like that, maybe you only want to be within 6 miles. And if you're within 3 miles, you could walk. So I'm sure there's a really cool diagram you could do showing the success rate based on transportation mode selected. I just don't have the time to do that, but someone could certainly come up with that genius idea. Kind of a scatter chart. You throw in your topographical info, where you live, where you work, and based on altitude, route, and various other parameters, it tells you your mode of transportation. You should walk. You should have a bicycle. You should have an electric bike. You should most definitely have a car. you know, that kind of a thing. Oh yeah, going back to that, when we lived, so we were thinking about moving out further, and you definitely could get more land, but now I got to commute. It's just like, in the thought of commuting, more than like I'm just doing 20 minutes, but I actually get a bit of a workout, it's way better. I'm going to miss that light. That light is way too fast. But at least I get a workout, it's 20 minutes, you know, each way, gives me a little something, I don't feel as guilty. But if I have to sit in a car for what would be an hour just to have some land and essentially pay maybe a little bit less in monthly rent, but when you add up the car and the discount and that thing, like I said, for my work where they give me $100 a month, you factor all that in, it's like, holy cow, I'd have to live really far out, probably 2 hours away, and then it would be cheap enough that it would compensate. But that's just really ridiculous. Give me 4 hours a day. Come on, sanity check. Gotta wait for this light. Interesting view. The light is right there. So right now on the bike, I could show you, but I'm like running out of cameras here. What's happening is my battery level is on E. Oh, dude. Well, it's okay. Now this could kind of suck. It's starting to flash E right now. I had the bike charging. Okay, really, bro? That's so not cool. Don't do that, people. My bike was fully charged, and then I unplugged it because I needed room in the garage, kind of got it out of the way because we were going up to Big Bear this weekend. Then I moved it aside for like 2-3 days. So it wasn't freshly charged. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. So I'm typically, I don't start flashing the E until like I'm almost home or near the home area. I would say I'm probably 2 miles back. Ah, see, it stopped flashing. So, but it is weaker, right? It's not its same strength that it usually is. It's back to solid because I'm more in a flat terrain. I'm kind of not doing full speed either. I'm doing 20 miles an hour right now. So the watt output is about 530. So I'm trying to conserve a little bit, like I'm afraid to pedal. But you know, if you don't have as much strength, here's something. If you don't have as much strength in your knees, like I don't necessarily have, I'm in pretty good shape, but I don't have a ton of strength in my knees. I've never liked to paddle boat, you know, that kind of thing. Where you're like, you sit down and then you have to like paddle boat. I'm just no good at that. I've never had the strength in my knees. I get weak super quickly. So with an electric bike, it really helps you because you're like, it makes biking practical. There's no way I could do this with a standard bike. I'd be like way back there. And I would just throw the bike down, pull out the Uber app and queue it up and be gone because I would never be able to pedal. So that's why I like the electric bike option. Okay, so we're flashing E again. Typically, this gives you a couple miles. I should be able to get home without too much issue. Let's take the pedal assist down to zero, and I'll just do this. Oh, this guy's gonna... All right, I'm gonna be respectful here, of course. Cool dodge. Let's see what's behind me. Let's see if I can get around. Okay. No problem. Cool dog. Hey, doggy. Little husky. Yeah. So it's flashing E. And now we're going to go and do the full speed here. But as it's anyway, where I was going with this is it does, if you do pull the bike away, I think with anything electric like that, you're charging with batteries, it will start to degrade
And then over time, you just have to charge it again. And this is kind of proving that fact. See, as I go slow, it's, there we go. It's steady for a while and it stops. So it's monitoring all the time. This way. Yeah, I don't know if you guys, other thing I would do is recommend is doing a search of electric bikes, like on Google News. You could do news articles, that's what I'd do. And there's a lot of new electric bikes. And this is still a really good one, don't get me wrong. I still like these guys. But there are others out there in the, it seems like this market is growing in a rapid pace. That bike looked like really wide handlebars. It didn't look like it was like a handlebar here, one over the other. Like, I need to tilt the camera this way and I can show you, but I'm like, all right, I'm gonna stop goofing around. I'm gonna eat it. See, these little random bugs, it's kind of annoying. That's why also I wear this also for the mic. So you wear the mic under here and then it cuts the wind noise really nice. And then on top of it, I don't have to worry about bugs. It's not for fashion. I know some of you are thinking, what is the deal here with this dude? Some sort of fashion thing going on, but trust me. Low hanging branch. One thing I would do too, I want to film, those are the small animals. cool looking dogs. Bell. There we go. So yeah, I wanted to film, removing the rear wheel and showing you guys how to like put it back on easily. And the things I did when I bought this bike, which include removing that one bracket. And also I took a drill and I made made more room, because what I found is that with the paint and the bolts, it gets stuck. And like one time I had a flat and I was trying to actually fix it at work, which is how I screwed up my wrist muscle there for a period of time. It's still kind of messed up a little bit, but it was impossible to get the damn tire off. It's like it was just stuck on, and I had to like kick and try to get the damn tire off. So I definitely recommend like just taking a drill and just like going around the outer edges just to kind of like get some of that paint off there. And because you need that rear tire to be able to come off. Now, obviously you want a safety first and you want to follow the directions, all that good stuff. But when you get a flat tire, if you can't take that thing off and you're in the middle of nowhere, it's a massive pain. Pretty much impossible. So highly, highly recommend getting that thing to where it come off. You want it to stay on, obviously, but you also want to be able to take it off when you need to take the thing off. So that's what I did. I kind of did that, and now I could take that tire off in a heartbeat. Really simple to do. Yeah, I still get fucking bugs, man. What the hell? This is California. We don't have bugs. So yeah, that's a strong recommendation. And then get yourself a tire liner, put your green slime in there, and as jacked up and as heavy as it's gonna feel initially, you do not want a flat tire. It sucks. A flat tire sucks. I mean, I've had it happen to me at least 5 times, I think, since I've had this bike. Now it doesn't happen anymore. I mean, there could be a hole in my tire for all I know. But I still got air, I still got everything rolling, so it's not my problem, at least not yet. Anywho, that's all I got. You guys have a great day. Subscribe, ask questions, and I hope this helps. So see y'all later. Bye.